Hey guys, welcome back to Pops and Props. Today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to turn this purge mask into this jigsaw mask from the puncher. So, let's go get started. So for the build, we will need a mask, and this is a purge mask that I got from Spirit Halloween. Next up on our materials list, we will need some sandpaper. I ended up using 220 grit. For the spray paint, I used a gray primer, a flat white, and also a gloss finish. I picked this brand because it adheres to plastic really nicely. Then for the acrylic paints, I got some red, blue, and some black. I chose two different blacks because I wasn't sure which one would look the nicest. And last but not least, some paintbrushes. These are very fine. Last but not least, I got some elastic straps. So first off, I decide to remove the strap from the mask. This will just make it easier for when I go in and sand it, just because it won't be in the way and I won't be struggling with anything. Next, I go in with my 220 grit sandpaper and I remove all the paint from the mask. I want this mask to be as smooth as it can be for spray painting. Now this is what the mask should roughly look like. I'm pretty happy with it, so I'm going to move on to the next stage. I take some wet paper towel and wipe down the mask for spray painting. Next up is the spray paint. I shake the can a little bit just to warm up the paint to prepare it for spray painting. You want this paint to be nice and warm so it adheres nicely. Now I just hang up the mask on a tree. I use some string to hang it up, and then I spray it with the spray paint. I do a pretty decent coat because I want it to look nice for the white that's coming up next. This is what the mask should look like now. I'm pretty happy with how it looks, so I'm going to move on to the white spray paint. So I just grab a plain piece of white paper. You can use printer paper. And I use this to gently sand the mask. This just removes any buffs and makes it nice and smooth for the next layer of spray paint. Now I go in with the flat white spray paint. Now guys, for drying times, I actually let this spray paint dry for about 24 hours before I went in with the acrylic paint to do the details. So next up are the details. So take a nice sharp pencil and draw the details onto the mask. I searched up a reference image to help me out. I thought it was really handy just to make sure I got everything screen accurate. This takes a little bit of time, so take your time, be patient, and make sure you're happy with the end result, because you can't go back after you put the acrylic paint onto the mask. So after I draw out all the details on the mask, this is roughly what it should look like. I think it looks pretty awesome, and I'm really, really excited to add the details. I go in with the black paint, and I do this first. I'm taking my time and being really careful with this because I want it to look really nice. Make sure not to apply too thick of a coat because it will take longer to dry. So, after I do a few of the black sections, this is what the mask looks like. I'm really happy with it, so I'm going to continue with the black sections and then move on to the red and blue. In this clip, I'm just taking the black acrylic paint and I'm outlining some sections of the mask. I also decide to do the teeth at this point, and I really take my time with the teeth because I think the teeth are a nice center point of the mask. Now, what I use for the lines is a nice fine point marker. You can use one of these micron markers, or you can use a Sharpie. I found that the micron marker worked a lot better. I do use the reference photo for these lines because I want to make sure it is top notch. There's the photo for reference. In this clip, I go in and do the cracks with the marker. I noticed that the marker actually smudged a bit on this mask, So I had to be really careful because I wanted this mask to look nice and clean. So after all the painting is done and you've gone in with the marker, this is what the mask should look like. Now I go in with the gloss clear coat. I do a nice heavy coat of this on the mask. Remember, guys, to let this dry for 24 hours before moving on to the next step. So this step's a bit confusing. I take the strap that I cut off from the beginning and I mark it out on the elastic and make a strap that would fit my head. I make it just a bit shorter because I know the strap will stretch. Then I get my lovely girlfriend Brooke to sew the strap onto the mask. Now I grab a pair of scissors and I remove the excess strap from the mask. I do this mainly because I don't want it to feel funny when I'm wearing it on my face. Now, let's take a look at the finished prop. So this is what the mask looks like finished. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. I think it really fits well, especially putting up the hood. I think it looks really awesome. It kind of hides the rest of my face. And check that out there, guys. I think that looks really creepy. I think it's really cool. I hope you guys like this. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Here's a quick look at the mask again. I am super happy with how it turned out. I'm gonna put it on one more time. I have to admit, it does look a little goofy with my hair just because my hair is so long. But if I do a cosplay, I might have to shave my hair. So this is the completed mask. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this process. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. And if you guys have any ideas for upcoming prop builds, just mention them down in the comments down below. And I will see you guys next time.